In this lesson, I want to get back to some straight code editing tasks, and we'll work in the HTML file. I'll show you how to indent and unindent blocks of code and how to move code without using cut and paste. I'm in the pc.html file, and I'm not going to start the live preview yet because nothing's going to change really in the display. All of the different sections I've created are inside of a div with a class of main. Each new section starts with the h2 tag. These sections also include the shortcuts div and the notes div, but not every section has notes. When we look at the code, it isn't easy to distinguish the different sections. I'd like to group each section inside of a section tag. So this area right here is the section. Right above the code, I'll create a section tag. Since my cursor is inside the tag, I can hit enter to put the two tags on two lines. Now I want to move the closing tag to below the end of the notes for workspace. Instead of cutting and pasting this line, I can just move it down. The shortcuts for moving a line of code down or up are found under the Edit menu. Now, these two shortcuts are different depending on the operating system. You can't just swap the Control key for the Command key here. On a Mac, it's Command plus Control plus down arrow. And of course, moving something up would use the up arrow. But on Windows, the shortcut is Control plus Shift plus down arrow. So this is down and this is up. I'll move this down to the bottom of the workspace section. But now the alignment of the code is not correct. I want everything inside the section tag to be indented two spaces. I need to select all of that code to indent it. Since my cursor is at the bottom of the selection, I can't use the Control plus L shortcut to select each line of text. Instead, I'll go to the beginning of the line and then hold the Shift key down and arrow up to get the entire section of code. Now, in many text editors, when you have a section of code highlighted, if you hit the Tab key, you can indent the code one tab stop. That will work here. And you can hit Shift plus Tab to unindent one tab stop. I use those shortcuts often. However, if we look at the Edit menu, the shortcut listed is different. It's Command plus right bracket to indent and Command plus left bracket to unindent. This pair of shortcuts is maybe a little more useful than using Tab because you can indent a single line of code no matter where your cursor is inside that line. If my cursor is inside the line but I don't have the line selected, if I hit the Tab key, I'll insert a tab right at that spot. But if I hit Command plus bracket, it will indent the entire line. So either set of shortcuts will work, but it might be better to learn to use the shortcuts with the bracket keys instead. I'll add the next section tag now for opening and closing files. Instead of moving the closing section tag down, I can highlight the entire section that belongs inside and move it up. You can move one line of code whether or not it's selected, but if you have multiple lines of code to move, you can use the same shortcut to move a block of code if you select it first. The nice thing about this method is that I can quickly indent that section because it's already selected. So this seems quicker to me, and I'll use this method for the rest of the sections. Before I finish, I'll add these shortcuts to a new section labeled Moving Code. I'm getting the shortcuts from a gist I have linked to in the lesson notes. I'm putting them before the Quick Edit section. So moving code up and down and left and right is quite easy once you learn the shortcuts. If you forget the shortcuts, remember they're on the Edit menu. They're pretty easy to remember though because you'll probably use them a lot. In the next lesson, I'm going to start talking about the powerful find and replace features in brackets.